Alaska Live TV. Music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska. Architecture and engineering for the new frontier.
Dirty Kitchen, join me here for Alaska Live. Welcome, you guys.
Thanks, Lori. Here we go with some scorching the gravy. One, two, ready.
Great.
Hello, Alaska. Top of the morning to you.
Well, we promised listeners that you would heat up the KUAC studios,
right.
And I think scorching the gravy did it well.
Ooh, it's one way to warm up and 40 below.
I know. Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen, will you, Frank, introduce your band for us?
Sure. On the guitar, hailing from Seattle, Washington. He plays in a number of bands down there, including his own called Northern Departure, and he's helping us out and doing a fine job on the guitar. This is Chris Luquette.
Welcome.
Yeah, man.
Hello there.
And on the upright, stand-up, doghouse, double bass, has many names, and he is an Alaskan. He was born and raised in Anchorage and played music for many years with his dad, Greg Booth. And this is Danny Booth on the bass, mighty fine singer, songwriter, and bass player.
Welcome.
Thank you. Good to be back here, Lori.
And this little thing called Facebook told me it's your birthday today,
it's
Danny
my
Booth.
Birthday.
So
I'm going to party like I'm 21.
Hey, all right. Well,
let's do it after
the gig tomorrow.
Well, I know you had quite the adventure getting here
to
Fairbanks.
Yeah,
because
Seattle got hammered, but we made it. We made it to find another day. Here we are. And I noticed
great.
When I walked in that you're wearing some of my wife's jewelry.
I didn't even realize that this was cosmic. But yeah, I have on something I got at an auction for Murray Nash down in Talkeetna. Year or two ago, your wife's piece of jewelry was there, and I was so taken by it that I bought it there.
Yeah, it's a piece of sliced caribou antler. It's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
I haven't seen that kind of piece in a while. They're usually a little bigger. It's a nice, small, delicate piece.
Yeah, no, it's a delicate caribou antler. And did you have a part in making this jewelry also?
I do slice the caribou antler now and again, and I probably sliced that one. Got a cross-section of it. Yep. And my wife's jewelry, Leah Sturgis Jewelry Art is the name of her business, and she's awfully talented, and she has stuff all over from Chicken, Alaska to New York City in galleries and shops all across the nation.
It's a small world. I love this necklace, and I don't own that many necklaces, so I wear it quite often, and I wore
awesome.
It today.
Yay! It is the universe is in our favor, then.
Totally
there you
is.
Go.
Well, what's next on the universe's set list here?
We're going to do a song that a guy named John Stewart wrote, and he...
Oh, like John Stewart and Stephen Colbert?
No, from the Kingston Trio, John Stewart, and is it one of my favorite tunes, and we'll send this one out to Buffy if she's listening. That's John Stewart's Widow. It goes like this.
Talking in my ear, and I used to run around with a gypsy girl named Shannon, the daughter of the devil. And it's strange that I should mention her to you. Haven't thought of her in years.
It's nice to think of July right now, too.
Right.
It's like, you know, 30, 35 below in Fairbanks, and that's below zero. And yeah, it's cold out. And Yeah. It's warm in here, though.
It's
you
60
guys are
degrees different from when I left the house in Virginia.
That's where you call home these days.
Yeah, Virginia. I'm living in Alexandria, Virginia. Mm-hmm. And it's right by D.C. There's a lot of stuff going on, you know. I joined the audition and then joined the Navy band. I was offered the position there in D.C., kind of like a presidential support unit. And went back there in 2003 and had a great experience and decided I needed something different. And here we are in Fairbanks. In wintertime. Yeah.
Frank, you're a former Alaskan. You grew up in Kodiak or Anchorage or both or
well,
neither?
I turned 18 in California. I went to high school, you know. I grew up in California.
Okay.
And then drove my 63 GMC pickup truck from Central California to Kasilof on the peninsula down there. And was planning on dropping off my mother with some cousins, and you know, I ended up going to Hunter Creek, which is a bluegrass festival, and playing with my friend Ginger Boatwright and Doug Dillard, and had a really great time. And I was telling the story to Chris a little earlier, and you know, I just kind of got locked into this wonderful community of musicians and people that just was like all open armed. You know, I was like, man, this is like my family, because I grew up with, you know, music and festivals and open armed, you know, and hey, come over for supper, come on, let's play some music, yada yada yada. And just, you know, fell in love with it and ended up staying. I now consider myself an Alaskan for sure. Yeah. You know, I was up here for the better part of 10 years, and definitely is home, you know. And I have dual citizenship, I guess, because California is kind of home too, but but I definitely feel more Alaskan than anything.
I love that your story is like so many others. I came up here to Alaska thinking it was just going to be a visit, or I was, you know, going to leave. And then I never wanted to leave.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly. Actually, we have a tune. That's kind of an interesting segue. I would love to send a tune out to all my friends here in Alaska.
Be great.
A cousin of mine wrote this song, and it kind of speaks of taking advantage of the time you have with your friends, because really you don't know if that time's coming again. It's called Hello Friend. It goes like this.
This old world has found a way of twisting through our lives and turning what seemed like moments into years again. Moments, days, or years, you're unforgotten. Hello, friend. Hello, friend. See, the years have slowed us down. It's good to see they haven't changed our style. Oh, let's talk about the good times. Let's talk about all those crazy things that we did back then. Well, this crazy world's caught up with us. Glad we're still the same. Hello, friend.
Is that Chris? Thank you.
friend. We may not see each other for a while, but well, you know how far the time is. Give him an inch, he'll take a mile. If this world finds its way of twisting through our lives and turning them moments into years again, well, then moments, days, or years, you're unforgotten. So long, friend. Isn't this life or the next life? It warms my heart to know that you're my friend.
Hello, friends.
Did you say your cousin wrote that?
Yeah, a cousin of mine wrote that. His name is Ty Smith, lives in California.
What a beautiful song. I mean,
thanks.
It just really encapsulates that feeling of immediately catching up with somebody.
Right.
You know, you haven't seen them in so long, and you're just right back at the same page that you were when you left.
I love that.
Yeah, yeah.
I love
and
that.
Alaska is so like that, like you were
totally.
Saying.
Totally. Come up here, and it's like, you know, I got my friend George. Hey, George, Janikopoulos. He says, hey, where are you at, man? You coming over for dinner? What's going on?
Yeah.
He sent me a text a little bit ago. It's like, you know, haven't seen him in who knows how long, and
here's,
it's already time to catch up. You don't even need to catch up, just
right.
You know, start from where we left off, I guess.
Well, you said your cousin wrote that song to say that you grew up in a musical family.
Yep.
To say that you grew up in a musical family is probably an understatement.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, my grandmother and her sisters and whatnot, they were, you know, they toured around and played like vaudeville shows. And
really?
Yeah, I mean, there's pictures of my grandmother as a baby, you know, and like people everywhere else, you know, in the family just playing music and having a big time. And my dad is 9th of 10 kids, and all of his brothers and sisters play. And then my mom, on my mom's side, she plays, and her brother plays a little and sings, and her dad played, you know, guitar and some campfire songs. And on my grandmother's side, on my mom, you know, mom's side, her aunts and uncles and whatnot were like concert violinists and cellists. And so I'm cursed from both sides of the family, I guess, to be a musician.
Some parents cringe when they hear their kids say, you know, this is what I want to do with my life. This is how I think I'm going to make my living. I really want to try at this.
I want to be a musician when I grow up. Well, son, you can't do both.
Yeah. But look at you. You're doing both.
Yeah, I've been pretty fortunate.
Yeah. And you chose to even try out for the Navy band, too, and
right.
You got on the ranks there.
Yeah, I went and auditioned for the Navy band. The next thing you know, I was doing push-ups at Great Lakes. And,
surprise!
In boot camp, yeah. Hey, drop!
Even the musicians have to go through boot camp?
Oh,
what?
Oh, yeah, right.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Just so you know, boot camp is not for sissies. No, I guess it wasn't too bad. I mean, I knew where I was going. I had a light at the end of the tunnel, you know. I knew where I was going after boot camp, so it was not a huge ordeal, I guess. But it was 10 and a half weeks of training, military training.
And then you got to tour with that band all over the world, right?
Mostly around the United States.
Okay.
The band that I was in had been around the world in China and Nova Scotia and Sweden and, you know, all kinds of places. Wherever the president would go, it was a presidential support unit, you know, so... You've heard of like the president's own. Well, that's the Marines, you know, and then the Navy is the world's finest, also a presidential support unit.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, but that's neither here nor there.
Yeah.
This is a band called Dirty Kitchen.
Yes.
This is my band right here.
This
Dirty
is your band.
And actually, our banjo player isn't here yet.
Oh, yeah.
What? He's flying in from Atlanta.
And, oh, good news. Not through Seattle, hopefully?
No, he is going through Seattle,
but we'll
see if he gets in tonight.
Speaking of your band, boy, they don't just have to be pickers in Frank Sullivan, Dirty Kitchen, they have to be singers too.
Maybe we should get Danny to sing one.
Hey!
Want to do a standard
sure.
thing? Or?
Sure. Gosh, I have something picked out.
Some all day?
Yeah, perfect.
All right. There
Great.
We go.
All right, that's how it's done. That's how you pick a set list.
Yeah. I don't know if she's listening, but if she is, I'll send this out to my mom because it makes me think about her every time.
And Danny Booth, you play bass and you sing, and you're one of the newest members of the band, right?
Heck yes.
And
heck yes.
Did Frank steal you from Kathy Kalick's band? Was that the last one you were playing with?
Oh, there's no stealing going on. Yeah, I go by my own volition.
Oh, good.
He's his own man.
That's right.
I do what I want.
Well, congratulations. I think that you made the right decision because you're here now, too, in Alaska, and it's so nice to have you back.
I can't even tell you how good it is to be up here.
Well, Danny, what do you have for us?
Well, this is some old day. You got that? Yeah, you got it.
Sure, man.
Some old day. One, two, three.
I've been working out in the rain, tied to a dirty old worn chain. Oh, dear mother, I come home some old day. Some sweet day now turn me loose from this dirty old calaboose. Oh, dear mother, I come home some old day. Some old day.
Singing to some old day friends.
Thank you.
Nice standard. You don't hear that one every day when you hear a bluegrass band, so bring that one out of the vault.
Yeah, I had to remember that one myself.
You did a fine job, Frank. You did a fine job. I see that you picked up the fiddle now, Frank.
It's my Fidel Castro. I got a fiddle and actually, this was kind of the instrument I first started on.
Oh, really?
And played for many years, even up here, you know. And then I didn't start playing the mandolin until I had moved to Alaska, actually. Some of the mando greats of Alaska, like Joe Page, you know, had a lot to do with my playing, and Bernard Glansbeek, and a few others, and just had a great time learning that instrument, and still learning that instrument, and the fiddle for that matter, too, but... How about we do a tune called Squirrel Hunter? You into that? This is old John
Squirrel
Hartford.
Hunter sounds great. Oh, yeah, John Hartford.
Reminds me of my backyard.
John
Squirrel
Hartford.
Squirrel Hunter. Thank you. Ah, makes me hungry for squirrel.
You know, they say the squirrels up here just aren't worth eating. They taste like, you know, pine tar, and they're little. But maybe down in Virginia, they'd be a little fatter.
We got some big fatties in my backyard. Yeah, that's for sure. I don't know if I want to eat them in this, you know, close to the city, though.
No, they might be a little polluted.
Might have a third eye or something. You never know. You don't want to eat fish out of the river up there either.
Oh.
You might grow a third eye.
Thanks. Can't go much longer without talking about the name of your band, Frank Solivan and Dirty Kitchen.
Oh, I was wondering when it was going to come up.
You know,
I was wondering. You asked.
I have to ask because I know that
it induces inquiry.
There's a song on your first album called Dirty Kitchen, but it has to be more than that.
Well, okay, so check it out. I love to cook, right? And like I was saying, my family is huge on not just music, but food, getting together and eating. And I think music and food are the two things that bring people together in such a beautiful way, you know? And I've worked in some restaurants and done some catering, but we do this thing like with house concerts now where it's kind of on that model where I come in and I'll cook a big meal for like 20 or 50 people, and then we'll follow it up. You know, of course, we have all the camaraderie and the elbow rubbing and the hanging and the, you know, just connecting with people on a different level other than just like a show at a concert hall or whatever. You know, it's really a more intimate way to connect with people. And, you know, because we're sharing the food, you know, I put a lot of love in that and a lot of passion in that, just like I do with music. And then we follow the meal up with a concert, with like an hour and 15 or hour and a half concert. And it's seems like not those people aren't just fans, but they're friends, you know, after a night like that. And that's what it's all about for me, you know.
I really like that about a house concert, too. Those are becoming more and more popular these days.
Sure.
People want to be close to the musician and get to know them and, you know, feel like you've made a new friend after that. And
yeah, dig it.
You come into people's house and cook for them yet, too, or cook with them.
Yeah, well, mostly for them. And I have cooked with some people. You know, hey, what can I do? What can I do? What can I do? Some people say, here, cut these onions up. I don't want to cry. I'm all about the happiness, people. They're tears of joy.
Well, you being a musician and a chef or cook or whatever you want to call it, you have to have some pretty good knife skills these days because you don't want to, you know, hurt the precious
My fingers are as long as they came when I was born, luckily. I haven't chopped any off. I've cut them a couple of times, but, you know, you learn your lesson pretty quick.
Those heal. You just can't, you know.
Yeah. I'm in the midst of writing a cookbook right now with some of my recipes.
I was going to ask you that.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
And you can actually find some, there is a how to cut up an onion YouTube video that I put up, how to mince an onion. But I expect to be putting more stuff up like that. And hopefully one day we'll, you know, maybe pitch some idea to Food Network or some sort of, you know, travel network or some sort of touring around playing music and cooking show. I don't know. That would be fun.
One of my favorite memories from the Winfield Bluegrass Festival, Beppe Gambetta, this Italian
of course.
Guitar player extraordinaire, he put out a cookbook one year. And he was unveiling it at Winfield Bluegrass Festival. And he had a cook-along. So he cooked and he had people cooking up there with him.
Oh, nice.
And they made bruschetta. And then he gave a concert. And
that's the way to go.
Yeah. His cookbook has like the suggestions of wine and music.
Little pairings.
And so,
I love it. Yeah. Oh, man. He stole my idea. Dang it.
No, you can do it too. You can totally do it too.
No, actually, we did something similar to that at the Gray Fox Music Festival in New York, where I cooked a big pot of chili verde, showed a big crowd how I made it, you know. And I did that actually last Friday in D.C. at a place called the Hamilton, where I did an example of how I cooked a certain dish, and then I made a big old pot of it, you know, in the back earlier that day, so everybody can actually try it, you know, and have a taste of it and see how good it really is, you know. Oh, it looks good, yeah. Proof is in the pudding, man. I want to taste that too. So I always make enough for everybody to taste when I do something like that. And we were going to try to do it at Wintergrass. I don't know if you go to Wintergrass down
in Seattle.
I'd like
to someday.
Yeah, it's a great festival in Bellevue. And we had talked with the promoters there about doing something like that, but I think they can't get around something with the kitchen or staff or something. I don't know.
Danny, Chris, do you get in on these house concerts and cooking in the kitchen?
Well,
Danny's done one.
I only did one.
Oh, nice.
And
Danny is fresh meat in the band, just saying. And Chris is fresher meat, just saying.
Oh, your day will come.
Yeah. So I definitely offered to help, but most of it was just trying to keep the guests entertained.
Good.
While things are cooking, you know.
You got to have that person too.
Yes, and everybody wants to come and help in the kitchen, but equally important is staying out of his way.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Other people don't want to get cut either, yeah. You know.
I've cooked a couple of cans of canned soup wearing my Frank Sullivan apron. So.
Yes, we have aprons. Actually, we had some delivered, so you can get them tomorrow night at the show. Yes. And some new hoodies. And, of course, we got CDs. We got I have three recordings that I've put out.
The latest one is great, too.
Thanks. Yeah, it came out August 17th, 2010. So hopefully this summer we'll get in the studio again, and we got some song ideas and whatnot coming together. So that should be exciting.
And, you know, just like this show has been already, your albums are a nice combo of instrumentals and songs with lots of vocals and harmonies and the story songs and the scorching instrumentals, like you started off with.
Yeah.
Scorching the gravy.
Yes. Yes.
So, that's keep doing that.
Okay.
Keep doing the good stuff.
Words of advice from Lori Neufeld. Keep doing what you're doing.
Keep doing more good stuff.
All right.
All right, well, more good stuff. Let's
Shall we do Dirty Kitchen Fellers? Being that we're on that subject, let's do this tune that I wrote. And I got the idea for this when I left the kitchen dirty and decided to pick my mandolin instead of cleaning it. Funny how names come about.
Yeah.
Guess where scorching the gravy came from?
Hmm.
My kitchen is feeling dirtier already.
Well, that may have helped a few people clean up their kitchens. You never know.
Yeah. A little inspiration, musical inspiration. I like that.
You know, you said that you had been inspired by your family and had a great impact on you. And I think you've been inspiring a new generation of bluegrass and acoustic players here in Alaska, too. Like, oh, wow. You had an impact on Barefoot, right? Some of those kids.
Yeah, actually, some of those kids were taking private lessons from me, and they were some of my students at some of the music camps throughout Alaska, and then they became, like, counselors at some of the music camps, and then, you know, put this band together, and they got some, you know, a lot of time playing, and they got some people behind them to help them, you know, get out there and play for bigger and better crowds. And now they're, you know, there's only two original members now, Jason Norris and Angelo Dean. Mm-hmm. But in fact, Danny played some mandolin in that band for a little while.
That's right.
And, you know, they're touring around. They're doing great. They're on the Americana charts, and they have a new record out. And you should check, anybody who's out there listening to this, they should check out Barefoot Band.
Well, heat it up with another tune, Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen.
All right, what do you guys want to play? How about D? We do Dark Hollow. That's an old kind of standard bluegrass tune here from the late, great Bill Monroe. He did this one, too. And a lot of people, the Grateful Dead, have done this, you know. I think I'm going to tune first. I was in tune once.
We have time. You tune because you care. It's all good.
There you go. All right. A little Dark Hollow in D.
Rather be in some dark hollow where the sun don't ever shine than to be home alone just knowing that you're gone would cause me to lose my mind. So blow your whistle, freight train, carry me far on down the track. Be in some dark hollow where the sun don't ever shine than to be in some big city, Lord, in a small room with your love on the mind. So blow your whistle, freight train, carry me farther on down the track.
Some of those bands that have done that before, and I don't know if Newgrass Revival ever did that song, but the way you did it just somehow reminded me of that band a lot.
Oh, wow. Thanks.
Yeah, well.
I love that band.
I do, too.
Loved that band.
Right. Well, they kind of broke up and did their own thing. Bela Fleck was a part of that. John Cow and all them.
Totally.
And
Sam Bush.
Yes.
Pat Flynn. Gordy Johnson.
Ebo
Walker, right?
Okay, you guys do love that band. You can list every former and member of it.
Right.
And, you know, there's, I don't know if there's a debate these days, because there's been a lot of, you know, growing and influences and fusions of a lot of different styles. And so there's, there may be a debate between traditional and newgrass, but I don't know, I see you guys falling somewhere in between.
Oh, cool. Well, I appreciate that. Yeah, we, man, I just don't want to be pigeonholed, I think, into some sort of genre. I think bluegrass, there's this talk of, you know, the big tent of bluegrass, you know, and all these bands that are under that, you know, big tent roof or whatever. Bottom line is they all stem from the same place, really, you know. It's just, you know, Bill Monroe himself would say, you know, he was an innovator, you know.
Yeah.
You know, if somebody came and played a Bill Monroe tune or lick or whatever, you know, okay, well, that's good, but what do you do, you know?
Wow, yeah.
So, I mean, I just want to make good music and play for people that enjoy what we do, you know, and hopefully we'll gain some fans or friends up here, you know, that enjoy what we do. And I mean, that's the bottom line. We just want to have a good time, make good music, make friends, make good food, you know, and not deal with any of the debate stuff that you were talking about.
Well,
you
know, I was watching a PBS show I was watching a PBS show about the banjo. I don't know. It was like an hour or two long.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you see
like
that?
Steve Martin was on that or
something? Yeah, Steve Martin. Earl Scruggs was talking about how, you know, he wanted to go play with those bands that had the drums and the plugged-in bass and the plugged-in guitar. He goes, look, guys, it's a good time. They like me. They like what I do with this banjo, and I want to go play that. You know, I'm not going to talk about, oh, I'm not playing traditional bluegrass these days. He's just like, I'm having fun. This is what the kids like these days.
So what the kids are listening to these days. Well, just for instance, like last Friday, I played this gig where I was saying a little bit ago where I cooked, you know, for the audience and showed them how I cooked something. But the band that I played with wasn't a bluegrass band per se. We had an upright bass, and I played mandolin, and another friend, you know, playing guitar, and another friend that played kungas and box, you know, the cajon, and steel drum. And we did all kinds of island tunes. We did some blues. We played some dog tunes, some jazz standards, everything but bluegrass, you know? And there was people that came, you know, at the beginning of the show, oh, we love bluegrass. We can't wait to hear some bluegrass. I was like, well, you're not going to hear much tonight, you know? And then on the other side of it, we have people that say, oh, I hate bluegrass, but I love what you guys do, you know? So I guess we're hopefully winning from both sides. I don't know. Like you said, we're somewhere in the middle, I guess.
Yeah, and you have to have your own style, and you have to, you know, strike out on your own path, and you're writing your own songs and making different friends. And so, and the way it is now, I mean, you can travel so much, and the internet has just brought in all these different styles that you can learn from and pick up. And so, it's understandable that would happen.
Yeah, well, it's just evolution, I guess, you know, music.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not, you know, beating around on... No, some people are, I guess, still, but, you know, skins and, you
know. Some people are.
Yeah, here in Alaska, a lot of Native people still.
Yeah.
I love that stuff, you know, but, I mean, we're not, you know, we're not doing that. We're hopefully bringing, you know, acoustic music or bluegrass music to a different realm. I would like to think that, I guess, you know, with our own take on it.
It's great.
So, anyway, we were talking about the Navy band a little earlier.
Yeah.
In the process of me getting out of the Navy band, you know, it was a process, let me tell you. It was like a second job
trying
to get out of the Navy. I did 6 years, 1 month, and 24 hours with the Navy band. And, but proud to serve and proud to, you know, be part of the military and all of that. And, you know, saw some guys on the plane today dressed in uniform and thanked them for their service. And, you know, that's just, you know, that's a big sacrifice to be in the military, you know. Anyway, what I was saying was, when I was getting out, I wrote a song about it. I want to hear it. Here it goes. I wrote a song called Together We'll Fly, and it's about new beginnings with the one you love. And here we go. And it's called Together We'll Get Her. Two, ready, and... Thank you.
been pinned way too long to a course I knew was wrong. Plagued by want of a better life, flicks my mind and causes strife. It's time to go out and do my thing. I don't need a prayer or a wing. All I need is you by my side, and together we'll changed to contemplate. Swift embark, don't hesitate. Saluting fate, the contented one is not as easy as I thought. It's time to go out and do my thing. I don't need a prayer or a wing. All I need is you by my side.
Wow.
I will say it again. You have picked up a new lineup for Dirty Kitchen that can not just play bluegrass well and acoustic music well, but boy, can they sing with you and harmonize with you, Frank.
All right. Yeah, guys. Sounding good, yo.
Good job, Danny and Chris. It's just sounding real nice. And you've got a banjo player that's going to join you for the rest of your Alaska tour.
Yeah, he's been with the band from the inception.
Great.
And actually recorded on a previous record with me that I was called Selfish Tears. And so he's been in the band the longest. Danny next. And Chris, this is his first gig with the band right now. You're looking at it.
Well, love that you're debuting here on Alaska Live.
Yeah, right on.
Well, our hour has gone very quickly, and do you have a finale?
Yeah, we do.
All right.
We're going to do a tune that I named, actually it's named after a mandolin that I played for a while, because the back of it was really bulbous and carved out of a really great piece of koa, and it looked like a salad bowl.
Yeah.
And it's actually not food related, but kind of is in a way. And here's one called the Salad Bowl.
One, two, ready. Thank you.
That's like rock and roll bluegrass right
that
there.
That is like rock and roll bluegrass. Salad bowl. What a nice way to end the show. Frank Sullivan and Dirty Kitchen, Chris and Danny, great to have you here.
Hey, thank you so much for having us. Yeah, nice to see you again, Lori.
Nice.
And thanks
to see
for
you.
Wearing my wife's jewelry.
Ah, no, how fun.
Cosmic, in the words of Lori.
Cosmic.
You can find full episodes of Alaska Live TV at KUAC.org. Alaska Live TV, music and conversation from the KUAC FM studio, is made possible by a grant from Design Alaska, architecture and engineering for the new frontier.